الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. All praise and thanks belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and may the peace and blessing of Allah be upon His servant and final messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As to our followers, my dear respected brothers in Islam, do you know a lot of the ayat of the Qur'an, ul-ulama rahimahumullah, they said that a third of the Qur'an makes up the stories of the Qur'an. A third of it is made up of the stories of the prophets, of the messengers, and stories of the past of righteous people that weren't prophets nor messengers. Hatta even in the ahadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, you find an entire section of stories, right? So ahadith in when Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam would be sitting among his companions and he'd narrate to them a story, and obviously the story wasn't narrated for the purpose of the story itself, but because there were lessons and there were benefits and guidance within the story. So Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam would narrate it and mention it to his companions radiallahu anhum. And most of these stories are stories of Bani Israel. Obviously, why? Because Bani Israel was the longest nation that ever lived on earth. And among Bani Israel came many prophets. Prophets came, prophets died, prophets were killed. Every prophet that would come and die or be killed, he's followed up by another prophet, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in the Quran. فَبَنِي إِسْرَائِيلِ إِسْرَائِيلِ is another name for Ya'qub. So Israel alayhi salam is actually Ya'qub alayhi salam, the one who had Yusuf alayhi salam as his child and 11 others with him. So Bani Israel are the children of Ya'qub, and they were 12 tribes, and from that many tribes and individuals and people came after that. So Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says in a hadith, حَدِّثُوا عَنْ بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلِ فَإِنَّ فِيهِمُ الْعَجَائِبِ. Hadith sahih, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, and he encourages that we consistently refer to Bani Israel, and that we consistently speak about their stories and share their stories over and over again. For Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says here, حَدِّثُوا عَنْ بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلِ. Speak about Bani Israel, mention their stories. فَإِنَّ فِيهِمُ الْعَجَائِبِ. There are really interesting and strange things that happened to them. And really, it was an interesting nation. And what Allah Azza wa Jal sometimes gave people, He didn't give others. And He made lesson in that which He gave tribes and individuals and so on. فَالنَّبِي صلى الله عليه وسلم, He mentions this hadith. And during his life, as we said, he mentioned a hadith of Bani Israel. And I will share with you one of these ahadith that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam narrated to us. And it is concerning Bani Israel. For Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, كَانَ فِي مَنْ كَانَ قَبْلَكُمْ ثَلَاثَةَ أَبْرَصُ وَأَقْرَعُ وَأَعْمَى. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said that they came much before you, during the time of Bani Israel, three men. And these three men, the first one, he had a disease, a skin. So he was a leper man, a person with leprosy. The other one was Aqra', he was a bald man. And the third one, A'ma, he was blind. So he wasn't able to see. And this is a hadith narrated by Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu. He said, إِنَّ ثَلَاثَةً فِي بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلِ أَبْرَصْ وَأَقْرَعْ وَأَعْمَى فَأَرَادَ اللَّهُ أَن يَبْتَلِيَهُمْ. These three individuals, Allah Azza wa Jal wanted to test them. Now let's understand something. Number one, al-abras, the one that has leprosy. Firstly, leprosy is a disease that up until this day doesn't even have a complete cure. The maximum that can be offered in medical advice and a solution for leprosy is that they're able to contain it so that it doesn't spread around the body. But as a complete cure, there is no such thing up until this very day. For you can imagine, this is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave Isa alayhi salam, one of the miraculous signs of Isa alayhi salam was وَأُبْرِئُ الْأَكْبَهَ وَالْأَبْرَصَ وَأُحْيِي الْمَوْتَى بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ. That one of his signs was that he's able to wipe on the one who had leprosy. Allah Azza wa Jal would cure that person by the permission of Allah. It was a sign, because even from then there was no cure for leprosy. Up until this day, there is no cure for it other than being able to contain it in one part of the skin and it not spreading. وَالْأَقْرَعْ bold. So this man was bold, and the third one, we said he was blind. Of course, when someone is blind, there is no solution for that as well. Allah Azza wa Jal wanted to test them. Well, you need to understand what this means, because their situation now, wouldn't you already expect that being a test? Someone has leprosy, the other one is blind, the other one is bald. You'll see how they speak about their situation and how they're disturbed by their own health and by their own situation. But Allah, but Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, Allah wanted to test them. But you'd already think they're already tested. So how is he going to test them? With what is he going to test them? For we need to understand that Allah Azza wa Jal wants to test them in a different way. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, وَنَبْلُوكُمْ بِالشَّرِّ وَالْخَيْرِ فِتْنَةً. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tests someone, it is not only with something that is bad and evil, right? So Allah Azza wa Jal, he says, نَبْلُوكُمْ بِالشَّرِّ. We test you with that which is bad and evil, like sickness, like the loss of wealth, like the loss of health, loss of a family member, being disabled, let's say, for example, any kind of sickness enters under the word وَنَبْلُوكُمْ بِالشَّرِّ. Poverty, famine, right? All of this is bishar. But Allah Azza wa Jal doesn't only test in that which is evil and obvious to be a test. Allah Azza wa Jal, he says, وَنَبْلُوكُمْ بِالشَّرِّ وَالْخَيْرِ, with goodness as well. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala now here is going to test them with that which is good. Let's see if they pass this test, the test of goodness. Now we'll see exactly what this test of good is. And what is the purpose of a test? What is the purpose of Allah Azza wa Jal testing someone? Allah Azza wa Jal, he says in the Quran about Sulaiman alayhi salam, when he referred to his entire kingdom, he said, هَذَا مِنْ فَضْلِ رَبِّي لِيَبْلُوَنِي أَأَشْكُرُ أَمْ أَكْفُرُ. All of this is from the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so that he can test me. What's the purpose of a test? أَأَشْكُرُ أَمْ أَكْفُرُ. Am I going to be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or am I going to be ungrateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? So this is the purpose of the test. The purpose of the test is to measure this servant here, to test him. Is he going to thank Allah Azza wa Jal for what Allah Azza wa Jal gave him? And if you're going to pass the test and really be grateful to Allah Azza wa Jal, what are the conditions of shukr? We're going to mention this. What are the pillars? What is something that you're supposed to do that as a result you get a tick for it and that servant has actually passed the test of shukr, right? And sometimes if the test is in shar, if it's in evil, what is required from a person is sabr, right? Is required from him sabr. Also there are conditions for that, but we're speaking about the test of being tested in goodness. For Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, فَبَعَثَ إِلَيْهِمْ مَلَكًا. Allah Azza wa Jal sent to these three people an angel. Of course, an angel in the form of a human. فَأَتَى الْأَبْرَصِ. He came to the one with leprosy, this disease on his skin. فَقَالَ أَيُّ شَيْءٍ أَحَبُّ إِلَيْكَ. Imagine this angel, now he's a human only. He comes to the person with leprosy and he says to him, what is the thing you desire in life? What's the most beloved thing you want right now? For he said, لَوْنٌ حَسَنٌ وَجِلْدٌ حَسَنٌ وَيَذْهَبُ عَنِّ الَّذِي قَذَرَنِ النَّاسِ. He said, are you asking me what I love? Well, there's one thing, one thing I desire is لَوْنٌ حَسَنٌ وَجِلْدٌ حَسَنٌ, beautiful skin and have a vibrant colored skin. You know, a beautiful color and a beautiful skin. شوف the greed. Then you'll see later on when we speak about the other two and compare what they wanted to him. But he's saying لَوْنٌ حَسَنٌ وَجِلْدٌ حَسَنٌ, right? So he could have just said, if Allah Azza wa Jal can remove this disease from me. He didn't say that. He said he wanted a beautiful color and he wanted a beautiful kind of skin, a natural skin. And that this kind of harm that is upon me, وَيَذْهَبْ عَنِّي الْأَذَى الَّذِي قَذَرَنِي النَّاسِ. And this harm that is upon me, this disease, I want that to go away because the people have disturbed me because of this. So people have been speaking about him. People are mocking him probably. People are teasing him for what he has of this disease. قَذَرَنِ النَّاسِ. Now you see, one thing, what he does wrong here is he tied his pleasure with the pleasure of the people. Since the people are displeased with him and how he looks, he's not happy. He's not content. If he was to tie his pleasure with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then the result would have been much different. And this is what we learn. One mistake he did was that he tied him being pleased with the people being pleased. If they were happy and pleased with him, perhaps he wouldn't have had an issue. But because they were disgusted by his look, قَذَرَنِ النَّاسِ, and they would always give him words from time to time that would obviously hurt him and harm him, as a result he fell down. He was let down by his people and it actually affected him. So that's the first thing on his mind when the angel came and he said to him, what's the most beloved thing to you? Imagine you could have asked for anything else. Gold, silver, I want half the world, I want this. You could have asked whatever he wants. But it seems to be that his health was the biggest worry and the biggest problem for him. This is why he pointed to this. So then, the angel, here in the narration it says, فَمَسَحَهُ فَذَهَبَ عَنْهُ قَذَرَهُ فَأُعْطِيَ لَوْنًا حَسَنًا. Allahu Akbar, Allahu ala kulli shay'in qadir. The angel wipes him, and all of a sudden, ذَهَبَ عَنْهُ قَذَرُهُ. The disease that he had, all of it just disappeared. As the angel wiped him, the disease disappeared. Not only that, فَأُعْطِيَ لَوْنًا حَسَنًا. And he was given exactly what he wanted, a beautiful skin with a beautiful, vibrant color. فَأُعْطِيَ لَوْنًا حَسَنًا وَجِلْدًا حَسَنًا. And a beautiful skin, exactly what he requested came to him. Now, this is a test in good, right? The first thing he was given was this beautiful skin, and his disease is gone. That's one. One thing Allah gave him that is good. Then the angel asked him, فَأَيُّ الْمَالِ أَحَبُّ إِلَيْكَ. What kind of wealth do you love? What's the wealth that you love? This is the second type of goodness Allah is going to give him. So he said to him, al-ibil. And Allah, if you ask me, and I love camels. With the camel from among the animals is the most expensive. So he hit to something really high, right? You can see the greed in this person already. He said, al-ibil. He loves the camels. فَأُعْطِيَ نَاقَةً عُشَرَى. He was given a she-camel. Yani a camel that is pregnant. عُشَرَى from the number 10. Because a camel, when it's pregnant for 10 months. So it's in its last month and it's about to give birth. So in other words, if you have a she-camel, a camel that is pregnant, that's double the benefit. Double the milk or double the meat if you're going to slaughter, or double the skin that you're going to benefit from, or double the ride when it grows and so on. Everything is doubled. And the angel said to him, بَارَكَ اللَّهُ لَكَ فِيهَا. Here, take it. Allah has already blessed it for you. بَارَكَ اللَّهُ لَكَ فِيهَا is not a dua he's making for him. Even though some said it was a dua, but the actual statement, barakallahu laka fiha, is an actual statement. He's saying to him that this camel, Allah has already blessed for you. Because watch eventually what will happen with this one camel that was given to him. فَقَالَ بَارَكَ اللَّهُ لَكَ فِيهَا. That's the first person. Allah Azza wa Jal removed his worries. In an instant, he removed his worries. In an instant, his worry was gone. And that was the thing that was always on his mind. Not only that, he was given two things that they were the most beloved and most desired things to him. Allahu ala kulli shayin qadir. Nothing is impossible. But into how are you going to respond to what Allah Azza wa Jal does for you? Whether in times of bad and in times of good. We'll see what happens. فَأَتَى الْأَقْرَعَ. So now this same angel, he went to the one that is bald. And he said to him, أَيُّ شَيْءٍ أَحَبُّ إِلَيْكَ. What's the most beloved thing to you? He said to him, شَعْرٌ حَسَنٌ. Beautiful hair. You see, he could have just said to him, hair. But he said to him, شَعْرٌ حَسَنٌ. Yani beautiful hair. Hair that stands out. Hair that people can praise me for, right? And then the people can make a point out of it. And say, MashaAllah, your hair today, wallah, it looks nice. Right? This is شَعْرٌ حَسَنٌ. The word حَسَنٌ, meaning I want it to stand out for it to actually look good on me. Not only any kind of hair, شَعْرٌ حَسَنٌ. وَيَذْهَبُ عَنِّي هَذَا الَّذِي قَذَرَنِ النَّاسِ. And that this kind of problem that I have, which is being bald, that it goes away, it disappears because, you know, the people already have spoken and they've slandered, they've mocked me, they've teased me and so on. I want this to go away because of what the people are speaking. Once again, this man has tied his pleasure with the pleasure of the people. If they're happy, perhaps he'll be happy. And if they're upset with him, he's going to be down as well. A person needs to understand that you belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You do not belong to the creation. So long as Allah Azza wa Jalla is pleased with a person, then you should be fine. We are around the people. If you try to please the people, this is a goal and it is a thing that you will never obtain, right? As the saying would say, رِضَى النَّاسِ غَايَةٌ لَا تُدْرَكُ. That attaining the pleasure of the people is something, is a goal, is an ambition, is an achievement that will never ever be able to be reached. You'll never reach it. So as long as Allah Azza wa Jalla is pleased with a person, this is what's supposed to keep the person content. So he said to him, so the angel, he said, or the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in the narration, فَمَسَحَهُ فَذَهَبَ عَنْهُ وَأُعْطِيَ شَعْرًا حَسَنًا. Do you see, being bald is almost half the problem as the other one. Then he could have covered his hair, he could have done something, right? But it seems to be that in that culture, they never used to cover their hair. And the other thing is, that this person was really, really affected by this. This was the biggest problem and biggest concern in his life. Therefore, this is the first thing that he mentions to the angel. So the angel wipes his head. فَذَهَبَ عَنْهُ. The baldness was gone. فَأُعْطِيَ شَعْرًا حَسَنًا. And he was given exactly what he wanted. Beautiful hair that stands out. قَالَ فَأَيُّ الْمَالِ أَحَبُّ إِلَيْكَ. Enter from the wealth and the properties and that, what do you love? So he said to him, Al-Baqar. And if you ask me, I love cows. فَأُعْطِيَ بَقَرَةً حَامِلًا. He was given a pregnant cow. So he took it, and the angel said to him, بَارَكَ اللَّهُ لَكَ فِيهَا. There's going to be a lot of blessings in this. Ya Allah, take it. Khalas, his problem is gone. That's the first goodness he was given. And the second goodness is that which he loves, which is the cow, and that's it. فَأَتَى الْأَعْمَى. So the angel, he went to the one that was blind. That's the last of the three. فَقَالَ أَيُّ شَيْءٍ أَحَبُّ إِلَيْكَ. What do you love? He said to him, أَنْ يَرُدَّ اللَّهُ عَلَيَّ بَصَرِي فَأُبْصِرَ بِهِ النَّاسِ. That's his request. You see, he's different. How is he different? He said, all I want is that Allah Azza wa Jal returns my eyesight so that I can see people with. Now, al-ulama rahimahumullah, they said, it seemed to be that this person used to see, right? Because he's saying that Allah returns my sight. In other words, he used to have sight. But the sight that he had, he couldn't see far with it. All he could see with his sight was people. That's all he could see. Things that are far, things that are more complicated, papers and writing and that, he couldn't see that. That's why he said, فَأُبْصِرْ بِهِ النَّاسِ. All I want is my sight to return so that I can see people with. That's it. Yani leave it as it was, damaged before. But I'm happy with that, just to see the people once again. And he didn't say, the people have spoken bad about me, the people have mocked me, and you know, I need this kind of feeling and this disease to go away from me because of the people's talks. He didn't connect his situation with the people. He just said to him, أَنْ يَرُدَّ اللَّهُ عَلَيَّ بَصَرِي فَأُبْصِرَ بِهِ النَّاسِ. For the angel, in the narration it says, فَمَسَحَهُ. He wiped his eyesight. فَرَدَّ اللَّهُ إِلَيْهِ بَصَرَهُ. Allah Azza wa Jal gave him his sight. In an instant he gave him. Allahu ala kulli shay'in qadir. قَالَ فَأَيُّ الْمَالِ أَحَبُّ إِلَيْكَ. What kind of wolf do you love? So he said to him, الْغَنَمْ. Sheep. Now, sheep compared to cow and camel is the least expensive. It's the cheapest. We even, the sheep in Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, السَّكِينَةُ وَالْوَقَارُ فِي أَهْلِ الْغَنَمْ or فِي أَصْحَابِ الْغَنَمْ. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said that humility and humbleness is found in the people of the sheep. Those who own يعني, many sheep and have a farm that has sheep, often you find them more humble. And you find that يعني, their character and their and their manners and their يعني, quality and so on, it's more humble, it's soft, as opposed to the people of the camel. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, يعني, الفخر والخيلاء في أصحاب الإبل. That the arrogance and the strength and this kind of boastful manner and character is found in the people of the camel. Obviously, because the camel is more of a stronger animal, a bigger animal, right? It moves around quicker and so on. It kinds to, yani, it affects its owner and it develops these kind of characteristics within it. Anyway, this man is very humble. He got his sight back, which was one blessing, and he was given another blessing. That is what he loves, and that is the sheep. فَأُعْطِيَ شَاتًا وَالِدًا. A sheep that was pregnant. فَأَنْتَجَ هَذَانِ وَوَلَّدَ هَذَا. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, so all these kind of animals that were given to the three gave birth to what was inside. فَكَانَ لِهَذَا وَادٍ مِّنْ إِبِلٍ. The first one, as a result, this one camel that he was given became a valley of camels. وَادٍ مِّنْ إِبِلٍ. Yani you can just imagine, a wadi min ibil, thousands upon thousands of camels he has. Obviously, it was a blessed camel. So it gave birth to all these camels, and one camel would give birth to another and so on. And you can imagine, if there's a farm that has camels, then you also have workers and you have slaves on the farm to take care of it. And you have buildings and you have business going and the milk that comes out and it's sold. And his entire business is made right now. وَكَانَ لِهَذَا وَادٍ مِّن بَقَرٍ. And the other one also had a valley of cows. And the last one as well, وَكَانَ لِهَذَا وَادٍ مِّنْ غَنَمٍ. And this was their situation. They have been tested in good. Many years go by. Obviously, if you're going to make a valley of animals, then years had to have gone by. right? For one to get pregnant and give birth and so on. And these went by. ثُمَّ إِنَّهُ أَتَى الْأَبْرَصَ فِي صُورَتِهِ وَهَيْئَتِهِ So this same angel came back many years later to the one that had leprosy. And he came to him in the form of a human in the same manner that that person يعني was. So he came and he had leprosy on his skin as well. And he looked poor. And he looked just like the person that he came to many years ago. في هيئته وصورته. Nothing different. Split image. فقال, now this angel is saying to him, the guy's wealthy now. He's got beautiful skin, beautiful color. He said to him, رجل مسكين وابن سبيل قد انقطعت بي الحبال في سفري هذا. He said to him, look, I'm a poor man and I'm ابن السبيل. The guy is mentioning two things he's got. One, مسكين. مسكين يعني poor. Look at the desperate state I'm in. وابن السبيل, ابن السبيل is a person that was on a journey. So this angel is making it out to be like he's on a journey. And if you're on a journey, and you, let's say nowadays you're in your car, all of a sudden the car breaks down, completely gone, you cannot use it anymore. So now you're considered Ibn al-Sabir. You need something at least to get you to your destination. Such a person is eligible for Zakatul Mal. So this angel, he gave two reasons for why he's eligible for Zakatul Mal. First, I'm a miskeen. Secondly, I'm an Ibn al-Sabir. I was on a journey. Whatever a donkey I had, a horse I had, it just died, it collapsed, it's not working anymore, and I need something. So he said to him, فَلَا بَلَاغَ لِيَ الْيَوْمَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ ثُمَّ بِكْ He said, look, I'm going to tell you something. I will not be able to reach my destination today other than by the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala first, then you. يعني I'm depending on you now. أسألك بالذي أعطاك اللون الحسن والجلد الحسن والمال بعيرا أتبلغ به في سفري. He said to him, I ask you. He did not say, I ask you by Allah, give me a camel. He said to him, I ask you by the one who gave you this beautiful skin and this beautiful color, right? Because it stands out. He said to him, and I ask you by the one who gave you all this wealth, give me one cow, one camel, بعيرا. Not because I love the بعير. But because I'm greedy for it, أتبلغ به في سفري, just so I can reach my destination. I'm in desperate need of a camel that would get me to my destination. That's it. I don't need it. I don't need to add in my property what I have at home, or it's because I love and a desire for camels. Look, it's really desperate. This is why I need it. So he mentions, يعني subhanAllah, three things. He's a miskeen, ibn al-sabil, and he needs to get to his family. He needs to get to his destination. Three reasons, enough to give someone something and say, Allah, يعني, make it easy for you and go away. So, he said to him, الحقوق كثيرة. He said to him, look, Allah, man, I got a lot of rights. I got debts to pay. I have a family to take care of. I have taxes to pay. Well, I got too many things. يعني, please go see someone else. الحقوق كثيرة. شوف, subhanAllah, what's wrong with this word, الحقوق كثيرة. But you should understand, that whatever you have of wealth, there is no haqq in that wealth except the haqq of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is no haqq in it to anyone other than firstly the right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the right of Allah azza wa jal is in your wealth is to give zakatul mal, at least zakatul mal. So he said to him, al-huququ kathira. Qala lahu, the angel then said to him, ka'anni a'rifu. ألم تكن أبرص يقذرك الناس فقيرا فأعطاك الله المال He said to me, you know, look strange. I think I know you, I've met you before. Didn't you have a disease when you, a leper man, you had leprosy all over your skin and the people used to shame you for it and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you goodness in your health and He gave you this wealth. Isn't that you? Here now He's reminding him that perhaps he forgot. So he's reminding him of the ni'mah that Allah Azza wa Jal gave him. And obviously, I'm reminding you of your ni'mah, so give me some of it. So you can thank Allah for it, and Allah can bless it for you. But this man didn't seem to be interested, even though he recognized and acknowledged what he was. So he said to the angel, no, no, no. إِنَّمَا وَرِثُ هَذَا الْمَالِ عَنْ كَابِرًا عَنْ كَابِرٍ He said to the man, I inherited this wealth from كَابِرًا كَابِرًا from كَبِير, meaning someone that's bigger than him, which is his father. عن كابر and someone that is much bigger than him in age which is his grandfather. In other words, he's saying, I inherited this wealth. My father, my grandfather, we used to have a business where people that are, you know, honored in the society, in town, were huge. So this wealth was passed down to me. Lying. You see what greed does? Greed leads to lying. This is why greed, in all of its senses, whether you look at the greed and its consequences, there's nothing good about greed. Eventually, what comes out of greed is something that harms and destroys you. So it forced him to lie. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, وَإِذَا أَذَقْنَاهُ رَحْمَةً مِنَّا مِنْ بَعْدِ ضَرَّةٍ. Allah Azza wa Jalla speaks about the situation of the human. That if we gave him a rahmah minna, we gave him a benefit and a blessing from us. مِنْ بَعْدِ ضَرَّةٍ. After he was going through so much hardship and difficulty, لَيَقُولَنَّ هَذَا لِي. All of a sudden he turns around with greed and he says, all of this is mine. He doesn't acknowledge the favor of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon him. So the angel said to him, okay, no problems. فَإِنْ كُنْتَ كَاذِبًا فَصَيَّرَكَ اللَّهُ إِلَى مَا كُنْتَ. Look, if you're lying to me, may Allah return you back into the same state you were before all this. And he took off. وَأَتَى الْأَقْرَعَ. He went to the bold man. And he came into the same form and shape of the bold man. So he came and there was no hair on his head. فَقَالَ لَهُ مِثْلَ مَا قَالَ لِهَذَا. And he said to him and described the same situation as he told the one of the leprosy. And that person, the bold man that now has been cured and has this farm of cows, responded in the exact same manner. Well, I can't go see someone else. I have a lot of rights to give and I took this money from my parents and my father and grandfather, and the same story. For the angel said to him, إِن كُنْتَ كَاذِبًا فَصَيَّرَكَ اللَّهُ إِلَى مَا كُنْتَ. Like, if you're lying to me, may Allah Azza wa Jal return you back into the same state and situation you were in much before all of this came to you. فَأَتَى الْأَعْمَى. Then he went to the blind man. فِي صُورَتِهِ وَأَهِئَتِهِ. So he came and he's blind and he's walking around like a blind man. فَقَالَ رجل مسكين وابن السبيل. I'm a poor man and I was trying to get to a destination, but my means of travel have been finished off. قد انقطعت بي الحبال في سفري فلا بلاغ لي اليوم إلا بالله ثم بك. And I will not reach my destination today other than by the help of Allah Azza wa Jal first and foremost, and then by you. أسألك بالذي رد عليك بصرك. I ask you by the one who gave you your sight back. شَاتًا أَتَبَلَّغُ بِهَا فِي سَفَرِ. Give me just one sheep. I'll use this sheep to get to my destination and back to my family. فقال. Now this blind man, he's going to respond. And he said to him, قَدْ كُنْتُ أَعْمَى فَرَدَّ اللَّهُ إِلَيَّ بَصَرِ. He said to him, I was blind one day. Allah Azza wa Jal returned my sight. We need to learn something from here. Sometimes you see someone that's sick, whatever his case is, being tested in his health, in his wealth. When you describe to him a state you are in, it brings comfort and peace to the one that's sick or to the one that's poor. Before you begin by even giving him something, speak to him and share your own feelings and how you are. It actually makes them more in a comfortable position, more peaceful, that to think, no, I'm not the only one in the world that has this. Others had this problem. So he said to him, look, I was one day like you. No problem. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he goes, أنا قد كنت أعمى فرد الله إلي بصري. Allah Azza wa Jal gave me my sight. فخذ ما شئت ودع ما شئت. Come, see this valley of sheep? Go inside and take what you want and leave whatever you want. Up to you. If you take it all, I'm not going to be upset. And if you are to leave it all, then well, it's up to you. فَوَاللَّهِ لَا أَجْهَدُكَ الْيَوْمَ بِشَيْءٍ أَخَذَتُهُ. He said, I will not say anything to you, no matter what you took of the sheep. Subhanallah, this person, what he actually did is he thanked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the blessing that Allah gave him, and he came with all the pillars of thanks, or the pillars of a shukr in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are three. Number one, to acknowledge the blessing. And he did that by saying, فَرَدَّ اللَّهُ إِلَيَّ بَصَرِ. So the first way in how you're going to thank a blessing that Allah gave you is by acknowledging the blessing. He said, I was blind and Allah gave me my sight. Acknowledge the blessing. Number two, attributing the blessing to Allah. He didn't say, I was blind and I was given my sight back. He said, Allah gave me my sight back. He mentioned Allah. In other words, he attributed the ni'mah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the third condition and pillar of being grateful to Allah is the gratitude of the limbs.
by giving that which Allah Azza wa Jal gave you and giving it back. And this is done when he said to him, خُذْ مَا شِئْتَ وَدَعْ مَا شِئْتَ. Take what you want and leave what you want. So he brought all the three pillars of ash-shukr. Subhanallah, this angel, he said to him, أَمْسِكْ مَالَكْ. He said to him, look, hold on your wealth. I don't need anything. فَإِنَّمَا ابْتُلِيتُمْ. All three of you were tested. Like, it's like these three, they knew each other. And they were like a story, and they were a common problem in their community. And when their problem went, of course, you know, if you know someone all your life that had a disease of leprosy, and someone that was blind for most of his life, and someone that was bald for all his life, all of a sudden you see them the next day and good skin, hair, he can see, it'd be a shock. They'd be on the news, right? They'd be on the front page, and this person found a cure for something that doesn't have a cure. So these people became news in their society. So they knew each other. For the angel said to the one that was blind, he said to him, all three of you are tested. فَقَدْ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْكَ. Allah is pleased with you. How did this person earn the pleasure of Allah? By thanking Allah. That's all. He did nothing but thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How did he thank Allah? He acknowledged the ni'mah from Allah. And he attributed the ni'mah to Allah. So acknowledged it in his heart. He attributed it by his tongue. فَرَدَّ اللَّهُ إِلَيَّ بَصَرِي. And he was grateful by his limbs, by offering and giving whatever he wanted to give from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's wealth that he gave him. That's it. As a result, he earned Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's pleasure. And the angel said to him, وَصَخِطَ عَنْ صَاحِبَيْكَ. And Allah Azza wa Jal was displeased with two of your friends, the other ones. So displeased, in other words, everything that he had was stripped away from him. And it went and they returned back into their normal state. وَاللَّهُ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٍ. For the biggest lesson we learn in this story, my brothers in Islam, is all of us in one stage of our life, we were poor. There was no one that was born rich. No one was born rich. Everyone was poor. Yet had they even in your physical power, you were poor. When you were in the womb of your mother, you couldn't even breathe on your own. Or you couldn't even eat on your own. You had to be fed through a tube, right? Look how weak and poor and in a shocking state the human being was. Allah Azza wa Jal took care of him during that time. Then you came out and you were weak and you were poor. You had nothing. And then you grew, then you went to school. What did you have in school as well, right? And then you graduated after that, you finished, you started working. Well, come on, you were poor. Yani you weren't in a state that you are now. Yani most of you, alhamdulillah, in a state that he wasn't as 10, 20 years ago, go back 20 years ago, for example. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he tests people the way he wants. You need to understand and recognize that what you have in your possession, the first and foremost obligation upon you is to look after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's right. To look after Allah's right. And the first right that belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in your wealth is zakatul mal. First and foremost, zakatul mal. But للأسف, يعني, up until this day, so many Muslims around the world do not pay zakatul mal. Now they made a study in the Arab countries that if the Arab countries were to pay their zakatul mal, poverty would disappear around the world. Allah Azza wa Jal set up the system perfectly. Yani Allah Azza wa Jal, when he created the creation, he decreed and he knew who's going to be poor and who's going to be rich. And by the perfect system of Allah, he obligated this thing called Zakatul Mal 2.5%. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with his absolute wisdom and infinite knowledge and perfect knowledge, he knows that if a person, if the rich was to take out 2.5% of his wealth, it is definitely going to cover the need of the poor around the world. No matter how much the needy were, the barakah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when implementing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's obligations. يعني, the fact that there are still poor and there is still famine around the world is a very certain indicator that still people haven't performed this obligation. Zakatul mal. For this is the first thing we learn from this story. Zakatul mal is the first haqq, is the first right that you're supposed to take care of and look after. Second thing is that you're always supposed to be conscious of your state and what you are. Just because you've become who you become, it doesn't mean that you forget how and what you've become, what you are. For here, it took an angel to come and remind them. And even when the angel reminded them, didn't you used to have a problem in your skin? Weren't you poor? Weren't you bald? Weren't you poor as well? When he reminded them, they were supposed to wake up. It was like a reminder Allah Azza wa Jal sent them. But they were heedless from this. For what you understand, that before you fall into trouble like this, always acknowledge Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's blessing upon you. We acknowledge it by your heart first and foremost, and then by your tongue. Al-shukr walhamdulillah upon the blessing that Allah azza wa jal has given you. Tashuf yani Allah azza wa jal, sahih, gave you two eyes. What's the purpose of the eye? To see with, right? So what's the purpose of this and the purpose of that and the purpose of the color inside the eye? So many blessings got to do with the eye, right? If the purpose of the mouth was to talk, then why does it have yani the lips, and it was designed the way it was, where it's got the upper inside, the many sciences involved with the mouth itself, blessing upon blessing upon blessing that Allah Azza wa Jal gave to understand. And understand what kind of meaning it is that one is healthy and blessed in his health. Then these people, the first thing that they had a problem with was their health. Yani, in other words, when you don't find it a problem that, I wouldn't even be in that situation to say that I want hair. In other words, how much of a blessing was the hair on your head, right? And the fact that you can see how much blessing is that Allah Azza wa Jalla has given you, that it was a desire and a wish for that person. When your skin, alhamdulillah, is fine and it doesn't need any care and it doesn't need any medical care for it. And that was a wish and a desire of a person that had a disease on his skin, right? For subhanAllah, a person is supposed to acknowledge these blessings of Allah, attribute them to Allah, give from what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given him. When someone poor passes by, when you find of a needy case before you, Allah sent it to you. Allah Azza wa Jal sent it to you by His decree, by His qadr, on purpose. Yet you think when you get a call from someone that's poor, or someone that's in need, or you pass by someone that's needy, masalan, for example, those who go to Saudi Arabia for Al-Hajj, and you see these many poor that come by, you think by accident you came by them? Or even in a country like this, you find about someone that is poor, someone that is stuck in a desperate situation. Do you think they came by accident before you and you just took off? Allah Azza wa Jal sent them on purpose to remind you of what you are and offer some help. Then if you do not offer some help, you're in danger of being وَسَخِطَ اللَّهُ عَنْكَ, that you earn Allah Azza wa Jal's displeasure. Part of being, executing the shukr to Allah Azza wa Jal is to not dismiss any case that comes before you at all. Nothing. If you cannot offer something physical and something materialistic, wealth or property or whatever it is, at least a dua, may Allah Azza wa Jal make it easy upon you, may Allah bless you, may Allah Azza wa Jal give you more than what He gave me, wada'ilu, make dua for it, at least he feels better with that. And Allah Azza wa Jal, He says, wa amma as-sa'ila fala tanhar, the one that comes begging and asking, do not turn him away. These are some of the lessons. One last lesson, ulama rahimahumullah mentioned, they take it as a fiqhi principle, and that is that it is allowed to mention stories of people, but without mentioning their name, if there is a benefit in it and it's not considered backbiting. So if you had a terrible experience with someone, the question is, are you allowed to share it and spread it and speak it to people? We say yes, if there's benefit in it, but do not mention any name. Just like this story, it spoke about people that went through something bad in their life, a bad story of a person, but Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam narrates it because there was a benefit in it and there were no names mentioned to it. Wallahu a'lam, as a fiqh principle, that is something that is permissible. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us people of the Quran, people of the Sunnah of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. We ask Him subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us of those who benefit from the ahadith and the ayat of the Quran. Innahu waliyu dhalika wal qadiru alayhi. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa baraka ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in.